We want to thank Google Science Journal app for supporting PBS Digital Studios.
Wake up and smell the Aquanet, because in the 80s, making a statement was all about the hair. There were mullets, side ponytails, poofy fringe bangs, and our favorite, the spiral perm, which many of us rocked so hard they even named a subgenre of music after it. But how did we get curly, big hair that's so bad it's good? A lot of teasing and a little bit of chemistry.
Thanks, Miss Beautyphile. So a single strand of hair is made of tough proteins called keratin. Now, whether you have straight or curly or wavy hair, each strand is mainly held together in two ways: hydrogen bonds and disulfide bonds. And it's these guys that let us create some outrageous hairstyles. Well, we don't want to be here all night long, so we'll make this explanation quick.
The name hydrogen bonds is kind of a lie. They're not actually bonds. They're just attractions between a slightly positive hydrogen atom and a slightly negative atom, like oxygen, fluoride, or nitrogen. The bonds are relatively weak, so much so they can be broken down by something as innocent as water. On the other hand, disulfide bonds are real bonds. It's a covalent bond that shares electrons between two sulfurs. Duh, it's in the name. These bonds are a lot stronger than hydrogen bonds and hold the shape of hair in an iron grip. This means we'll need something stronger than water to change them.
So here's how the 80s used these bonds to create some iconic looks. Since hair strands are semi-permeable, water molecules from the atmosphere can jump in between the hydrogen bonds of cross-linked proteins. These extra water molecules make your hair more flexible, but harder to keep styled. These crimson curls you see here were all achieved by changing the hair's hydrogen bonds with heat. When the heat of your crimper or curling iron is added, the heat evaporates the water molecules out of your hair. This allows the keratin to reform those bonds directly with one another, fixing your hairstyle into place. Just don't leave your crimper plugged in or you'll end up burning down the house. But this change is only temporary. Water molecules from a shower or just in the air tonight can sneak back in between those hydrogen bonds. So instead of having a protein linked directly to itself or its neighbor, water molecules disrupt the hydrogen bonds. In high humidity, this can give us the frizz that's the start of a bad hair day, and it's why breaking a sweat in gym class can cause your hair to lose its curl. Super lame.
Chemistry solved this problem with permanent waves. The glory of the perm is that it lasts. So you spend less time doing hair in front of the mirror and more time rocking out to tainted love. What made perms totally tubular is they use compounds like ammonium thioglycolate to break those strong disulfide bonds in the hair's natural structure, allowing us to mold a new style. But that grody rotten egg smell when you get your hair perm, don't wig out. It's just the unpleasant smell of the sulfur-containing thiols in the thioglycolate waving lotion being released into the air.
Here's how the perm works. First, the hair is wrapped in curling rollers. These guys hold the hair into place, but more on that in a minute. Next, we break out a thioglycolate perming solution to break those disulfide covalent bonds. Once they're broken, we need to reform them in a new place to get that permanent curl, which is where those rollers come into play. Hydrogen peroxide is used as an oxidizing agent to reform the strong bonds everywhere, convincing the hair to hold that new curl, potentially for a long time. Righteous.
Lest you think 80s hair will make a comeback, these styles could be really bad for your hair. While heat styling is considered temporary, the damage it can do to hair is permanent, leaving your hair living on a prayer. Drying hair for long periods of time at high temperatures can denature proteins, making your crimp limp. And unfortunately, every time you chemically perm your hair, a percentage of the disulfide bonds don't reform, leaving hair a little weaker and a little more damaged, making you prone to more bad hair days. At least until another decade brings another horrible hairstyle into fashion. Here's looking at you, man bun. And of course, it isn't truly the 80s until you've finished everything off with half a can of hairspray. But for that, we've got another video, which we'll link to below.
So that's the chemistry of crimping, curling, and permanent waves. If you've got more questions about the chemistry of beauty, send them to us or our good friend Miss Beautyphile, and maybe we'll take them on. Thanks to Google for supporting PBS Digital Studios. Their mobile app, Science Journal, lets you take notes and measure scientific phenomena such as light, sound, and motion using your phone, tablet, or Chromebook. You can find activity ideas and additional information on their website at g.co/sciencejournal or check out the link in the description below. Thanks for watching. We love making these videos time after time, even when deadlines put us under pressure. So help us out by subscribing, hitting the bell to get notified, and getting in the spirit of video by sharing with your friends. We'll see you next week.